Hello everyone. In this session, we are going to see about data processing instructions of ARM. Data processing instructions are used to manipulate data within the register. There are five data processing instructions: move instruction, arithmetic instruction, logical instruction, compare instruction, and multiply instruction. Most of the data processing instructions can process one of their operand using the barrel shifter. Barrel shifter, it is used to manipulate any of the operand or any of the register data before it's used by the instruction. So this is called pre-processing. So after the pre-processing, only the instruction will use the content of the register. Next, when we are using the S suffix in the instruction, that instruction will update the CPSR flag. CPSR, we have seen in the last video, there are four fields in CPSR. One field is called condition field. In that field, there are five flags. So based on the result of the instruction, that instruction will update any of the flag in CPSR field. We'll see move instructions. Move instructions are copying data from source to destination. Here the source is N and the destination is register. This source can be any register or immediate data. We will see the syntax: first instruction, then condition, then S suffix. These two are given in flower bracket. So which are given in flower bracket, that are optional. So condition may or may not be, and S suffix may or may not be. If S is present in the move instruction, then that instruction, based on the movement, it will update the CPSR flag. There are two operands for move instruction, only two operands: source and destination. This is N and destination register. So data from N field will be moved to R D register. There are two instructions in move group: move and move negative, MOV, MV, N. Move instruction, it copies the content of N to the R D register, but MV, N, it moves the not of the 32 bit value into the register. First, it will invert the content of N, then it moves the content to the RD register. We'll see one example. R5 is taken as 5, R7 is taken as 8. The instruction is move R7 comma R5. These are the operands for the move instruction. This is N, this is RD. So the content from R5 will move to R7 register. Content of R5 is 5. That moves to R7 register. So after the execution, we can see in the post after the execution, R7 is having 5, but the R5 content will remain same. Nothing will happen to that content. It will remain same. Next, we'll see what is barrel shifter. All the data processing instruction in ARM are processed within the arithmetic logic unit. One of the most powerful feature in ARM processor is it's the ability to shift the 32-bit binary pattern in one of the source register, left side or right side, by a specific number of positions before it enters into the ALU. This is called preprocessor. So before the content is used by the instruction, it will be preprocessed by the barrel shifter. This is nothing but a shift only, either left side or right side. This preprocessing or shift occurs within the cycle time of the instruction. Means we know that all the RISC instructions will be executed within a cycle. So this also will be completed within that particular time of the particular cycle time. What is the use of this barrel shifter? It increases the power and flexibility of many data processing instructions, and also it is useful for loading the constant into the register, and it is used to achieve fast multiply and fast division by the power of 2. This is the block diagram. Arithmetic logical unit. There are two registers are used here, RN and RM. RN enters into the CPU without any pre-processing. Without any pre-processing, RN enters into the CPU. ALU. But this RM register, it is pre-processed by the barrel shifter. So this shifter will shift the RM content either by right side or left side. The result of this barrel shifting is known as N. Now the N will be given to the arithmetic logic unit. Arithmetic logic unit, it will do the process between this RN and N, and it produces the result RD. We'll see the example. In this example, R5 is taken as 5, R7 is taken as 8. Insertion is move R7, R5, LSL as 2. So this is barrel shifter operation, logical shift left by 2 bits. These are the two operands of move insertion, R7 and R5. Actually, for this insertion, the content of R5 will be moved to R7. But with the content of R5, this will be pre-processed by the barrel shifter, then only it will be used by move. So as I said, the barrel shifter, it will operate on the register before the register is being used by the instruction. So first, in this instruction, first this operation will be completed. First this left shift operation will be completed. Once the operation completed, then the move operation will happen. So this left shift will be done for the R5 register. R5 register content is 5. Here it is given in decimal form. We will convert this decimal into binary number. So when we convert 5 to binary number, we will write all the 32 bits. 0000000. This is 5 binary bits, bit 0 to bit 31. Now we will shift this R5 content to the left side by 2 bits. This is immediate data 2 bit. So what we will do from the left side, left side means MSB we have to check. If it is right side, LSB we have to check. From the MSB side, 2 bits we are shifting out. And in the LSB side, 2 more zeros we have to include. So whenever we are shifting left side, we will remove that particular number of bits out, and that many number of bits we will include as in the LSB side as zeros. So 2 bits we have shifted out, 2 bits we have to insert in LSB side, that 2 bits are zeros. So now the new data is 0000014. This is the new data. It's in the form of hexa. But in the program, we are using decimal form. So we have to convert this 14 hexa into decimal. So when we convert 14 h, it is 20 decimal. So now the new value of R5 is 20. New value of R5. After the left shift by 2 bits, the value of R5 is 20. That will be moved to R7 register. So after the execution, we can find 20 in R7. After the execution, 20 is present in R7. R5 will remain same. And I told these instructions are used for fast multiplication. We can see here, if it is LSL as 1 means we have to multiply by 2^1. If it's as 2, we have to multiply by 2^2. So here we got as 2 means we have to multiply the content of R5 by 2^2. 2^2 is 4. So we have to multiply R5. R5 content is 5. 5 into 4 is equal to 20. So the new value of R5 is 20. 20 will be moved to R7 register. So this is how this barrel shifter is used for fast multiplication and division. Next, another example we will see here. Here CPSR content is given. CPSR N, first 5 are flag. Next 2 are interrupt. Interrupt, fast interrupt. Next is thumb state. Next is mode. User mode is used. Two registers are given. R0. R0 is 0. R1 is taken as 80000004. Now we are insertion is move S. S is given. S suffix is given. So this insertion has to update the CPSR flag. R0, R1, LSL, hash 1. So to the R1 register, we have to do left shift by 1 bit. First we are converting. This R1 connect is A0004. This we will convert this into binary. So when we convert 0 to 1, we have written here all the 31 bits are written. From the bit 0 to bit 31, all the 32 bits are written here. Now we have to shift the last bit to the left side. So we will move the MSB bit out. So one is shifted out. So since the one is shifted out, this will be considered as carry. So in the CPSR flag, carry flag will be set. It will be mentioned as capital letter. So as we shifted one bit out, we have to has to be shifted the 31st bit out. We have to include one more bit in the LSB side. We have to always include 0 in the LSB side. So now the new value of R1 is 0000008. So here input we have taken is 8000004. When we shift one bit to the left side, we are getting this result. So this is the new data of R1 register. This content will be moved to the R0 register. So in the after the execution, we can find this data in R0 register. So it is here in the after the execution. R0 is equal to 0000008, and we can see CPSR register carry flag is set. So there are five flags in the CPSR: negative flag, zero flag, carry flag, overflow flag, saturation flag. We have shifted 31st bit out, that was 1. If it is 1, it will be considered as carry, so we have to set the carry flag. So we are writing C in the capital letter.